Welcome inside Columbia, South Carolina's Colonial Life Arena. It is loud, it is packed, and they are here to see, and you can come along for the ride, what is right now the best show in basketball. Number one, South Carolina is 21-0, while the teams ranked number two keep going down to defeat. Number one keeps getting stronger. Their average margin of victory, 35 points a game.
And the Carolina success is built on the foundation of defense. You're looking at one of the top, the top team in scoring defense in the country and the number one team in block shots. And Eric, the offense is clicking. The number one team in field goal percentage from three, averaging nearly seven made buckets a night. It has become a strength of the South Carolina offense. And they haven't been in many close games this season, but when their backs have been against the wall, they were ready and able to make the big shots. Bree Hall with two big threes and that huge win over LSU.
And right from the opening tip of the season, showtime has been in full effect. You never know what you'll see, but you'll be on the edge of your seat when you see it. Malaysia Fulwiley. How about Ashlyn Watkins above the rim? It is guaranteed to be something memorable. You put that all together and you put it on the floor in front of thousands each night and you have Carolina Showtime. As we welcome you to SEC Network Basketball presented by Regions, the undefeated and number one South Carolina Gamecocks. Welcome in the Missouri Tigers. Eric Freed, Christy Thomas-Scuddy here with you on a Thursday night. Robin Pinston's crew shorthanded coming here to take on South Carolina. They were shorthanded in December of 2021 when they pulled off an unforgettable upset, knocking off then number one South Carolina in Columbia, Missouri. We'll see if lightning can strike twice. They are missing Missouri's their leading scorer and rebounder, Haley Frank, day-to-day with an injury. Camila Cardozo with the Brazilian national team at the Olympic qualifier, unable to go here today for Dawn Staley's team. We're ready to go. We're underway here at Colonial Life Arena, and the opening tip still being fought for and finally controlled by Mama Dembele, the outstanding point guard for Mizzou in the road black. Looking inside to Ashton Judd. Judd tried to drop it down to Hannah Linthicum. It's a double dribble, so a turnover. And here's the South Carolina starting five. Te-Hina Pau-Pau, number two in three-point shooting in the country. Ashlyn Watkins, back-to-back double-doubles. Bree Hall has been outstanding. Raven Johnson, 19 assists, three turnovers in the last three games. And Chloe Kitts back in the starting five with Cardozo in Brazil. And the turnover taken away by Dembele for Missouri.
Two possessions for South Carolina, two steals by Dembele here early in this game.
The freshman, Hannah Linthicum. Dembele with the shot clock, now down to 10. Looked for the call, didn't get it, and here comes Bree Hall back the other way for South Carolina. Missouri recovers defensively, now Pau-Pau. Pau-Pau, good dribble. That's Dembele with the quick hands again. She is so disruptive, so good defensively. She knocks it out of play. It'll be South Carolina possession.
And Eric, you mentioned no Haley Frank for the Mizzou Tigers, but the last time they played, there was no Mama Dembele, so a very different-looking Mizzou ball club facing off against South Carolina here this evening.
Watkins trying to get the handle back, kicks it out to Raven Johnson. Johnson with seven on the shot clock, gets the leaner, won't drop, and a rebound controlled by Abby Fites. Starting five for Missouri includes the freshman shooting from the corner. That's Grace Slaughter knocking down the three for the game's first points. Dembele at the point. Judd, Fite, and Linthicum round out the starting five for this Mizzou team. Hall on the take. No, and tapped out of bounds. Last touch by Mizzou. It'll be South Carolina basketball. So, Christy Thomas-Scuddy, break it down for me. No Cardozo for South Carolina. No Frank for Missouri. How do game plans change for these two teams?
Well, I think for South Carolina, on the defensive end, I actually think it's a better matchup for them because of how Mizzou wants to spread the floor. I think the biggest piece for South Carolina will be what we just witnessed. Can they still continue to own the offensive glass? And then for this Mizzou ball club, they faced off against Tennessee on Sunday without Haley Frank. Still were able to operate in the half court. But not quite against the shot blocking skills of Ashlyn Watkins in the half court.
58th block of the season for Watkins.
And you see she's beat coming from the weak side, but that's her athleticism, her explosiveness off the ground to get up and block that shot.
So you would think South Carolina is going to be lacking a little bit in the shot block category because of Cardoza being away, but no, that's not the case. Watkins, an outstanding shot blocker, and how about this for Missouri? They're going to need to make how many threes, would you have to guess tonight, Christy, to hang with South Carolina tonight?
Well, they made 10 in the first matchup and still didn't win, so I'm going to up that to about 13 tonight.
Watkins and the foul and a chance for a three-point play. So South Carolina's on the board after falling behind 6-0 in the opening minutes.
Well, Ashlyn Watkins has just been shining in her previous two starts. Here, no Cardozo. Ashlyn Watkins says, no problem. Get me the ball down low, and I'm going to work.
Watkins, as I mentioned, back-to-back double-doubles. 5 total this year. 15 of 18 from the field in the last 5 games, finding that offensive game as this season moves along. Linthicum threw it away. Race for the loose ball. That's going to be a turnover on Missouri.
And that's a youthful mistake by Hannah Linthicum there. That's where you just want to eat the turnover and allow your defense to get back and get solid in the half court.
Youthful kind of tells a story for Missouri right now. They have 2 freshmen in the starting 5. 4 freshmen will play here today for the Tigers. Here's Chloe Kitts. Kitts on the drive for 2. Kitts missed the Auburn game due to illness. Got back into the swing of things off the bench against Ole Miss last time out. Played 15 minutes. Looks to be, after watching her this morning, good to go. Green light for her. Back in the starting lineup today. Fight will try a 3. Not this time. And Raven Johnson's got the rebound. Here comes the point guard for South Carolina, who has outstanding speed. Feeds it inside, tough pass for Watkins, and Dembele comes away. Dembele's got great speed. Great point guard matchup here tonight. Dembele drops it off to Judd. Judd will try. That's no good. And a rebound for Pau Pau.
Well, as you're seeing, because Mizzou's spreading the floor, when that three-pointer goes up, there's no one in the paint to try to offense a rebound for Mizzou. So a lot of pressure on their transition defense here this afternoon.
And a foul's going to be called on Mizzou. First substitutions of the game coming on. Tessa Johnson will check in for South Carolina. Pair of 5's coming on because Micah Fedrape is coming in for Missouri. Raven Johnson checks out.
And you're seeing Mizzou on baseline out of bounds plays going into a 2-3 matchup.
Johnson just into the game, launches from 3. Second chance here, Hall. I think that's going to be a travel. That is the correct call. Turnover for South Carolina, Mizzou ball.
One thing to watch when Mizzou is in that 2-3 matchup, they talked a lot today about defending Pau Pau and Hall on the floor together. Well, the chess match begins because Dawn Staley now puts in a 3rd 3-point shooter for South Carolina in Tessa Johnson.
Abby Schreck, freshman, comes into the game for Missouri. Schreck, good 3-point shooter at 39%. She's in the right corner. It's batted around and grabbed by Watkins. Turnover number 3 for Mizzou. Kitts. Kitts turning on the freshman Linthicum. Watkins showing range. Seven unanswered points for South Carolina. 5 scored by Watkins. The crowd makes a little noise here with South Carolina in front for the first time tonight. Dembele lost the handle. Jump ball possession arrow will keep it with Missouri with 10 on the shot clock. So without Haley Frank here today, 17.5 points a game, 6th in the conference. better than 6.5 rebounds. That's 13th in the conference. How does Robin Pinchton change up the pace? Any other tweaks that you think she needs to make here today to stay with the number one team in the country?
Well, she's got one of the top point guards in the SEC in Mama Dembele. And when Mama's on the floor, it's all about pace. And so Robin Pinchton said, we're going to look to try to run when we have the opportunity so we don't have to go against the half-court defense of South Carolina.
Slaughter with a tough drive and throws it up for two. Grace Slaughter's got five, averaging 11.5 a game, third on the team in scoring. Pow Pow step back three is short. Save back out to Johnson. And a stoppage here. That's going to get us to immediate timeout. They're going to just check the shot clock here. We'll take the timeout as well. You talked about Mama Dembele. I want you to talk more about the talented point guard from Missouri. And I know you'll do that when we come back. Back here in Columbia, we're just getting going here between Mizzou and number one South Carolina. Eric Free, Christy Tomascutti, honored to be with you here tonight at Colonial Life Arena. This is a Missouri team that's been battling injuries all season long. A lot of teams are fighting through that, and Robin Pinchton told us today, it's like, we're not alone, but they are down three starters here today. One constant and very consistent performer has been Mama Dembele. You know that name. We've said that name for several years now, but she has really elevated her game this year especially.
And it's so obvious when you watch her play, the pace of play. This team goes as Mama Dembele goes. Mama has increased her field goal percentage, her three-point field goal percentage, her free throw percentage, her rebounds, her assists. And oh yeah, already three steals in this game. Those are up as well. You see how quick her crossover is, how quick her hands are on defense. Quick, quick, quick. That is Mama Dembele. And she has moved herself into discussion as one of the top point guards in the SEC.
How about in the country as well? Because she's fourth in Division I in assists. Already three steals here today. So you talked about how disruptive she can be defensively. The problem for Mama and her Missouri teammates here today is her number one go-to, Haley Frank, is unable to play here today. And you see how she's been a little bit different on the road, so this is not an environment that she should be fearful of playing in.
I mean, just look at the opening couple of minutes of this game. She came out and was already disruptive on defense, but to your point, Eric, I agree. The rest of the Mizzou players have to be able to step up and make some of these shots.
Watkins left alone, missed. Here's Fulwiley into the game and wastes no time being a difference maker, knocking down a three-pointer to put South Carolina back in front.
I really challenge the folks at home to listen when Fulwiley gets the ball, because this place goes quiet in anticipation of what she might do with the ball in her hands.
And how about how improved she is defensively? She was so disruptive there on Dembele, who almost turned it over. Great matchup to watch here between Dembele and Fulwiley, but now on the switch, open three in the corner is way long, and it's a rebound for Sanaya Fagan into the game. Here's Fulwiley, head up, don't know what she's gonna do with it, so you can't take your eyes off her, especially if you're a teammate of Fulwiley's. Tipped in the hands of Dembele.
And for the bigs for South Carolina, Mizzou is willing to give up that 15-foot jumper to them in order to stay between them and the bucket and just try to crowd around the rim.
Turnover picked up by Pow Pow. Numbers the other way for Wiley on the pull-up. Quick five.
I asked Robin Pinchton today, does Mama Dembele have a feel for the game? Because she says, we want to push pace, but you know South Carolina can go on a 10-point run before you know it. And she said, it's something I have talked to Mama about all week to make sure that we're staying in control, trying to stay in control of this game.
Beautiful little fake, but it just won't drop for Fedrape. And once again, here's Fulwiley. Full speed for Fulwiley, but a little too deep. Not done yet, though. Watkins cleans it up. And now Robin Pinchton wants to slow things down, and she'll take a timeout. And look at this crowd respond. That Fulwiley spark got this crowd going as well.
Fulwiley points, Fulwiley speed. Fulwiley is just making an impact.
You're saying
very
the
early.
Fulwiley right here.
It's the Fulwiley package.
Fulwiley, we got to work on that.
Yeah.
We had all day. We need to be, because we're saying her name a lot. But Malaysia, the freshman from right here at Columbia, SEC Freshman of the Week for the second time this season. Her defense, according to Dawn Staley, has been making great strides in recent weeks. What have you seen?
She's always had the speed. What I see is tremendous maturity from a freshman, because most freshmen this time of year are hitting a wall, and they're just waiting to get better in the offseason. That's why this young lady impresses me so much. She's taken the coaching from this staff, and she's applied it. Quick hands, quick feet. She is disruptive now on the defensive end for her team.
Had 14 points in 21 minutes last time out against Ole Miss. That was a win here on Sunday, 85-56. Six were in double figures. It was a tight game. South Carolina was up one with under three to go in the second quarter, but then they outscored Ole Miss 53-25 the rest of the way, an 8-0 run to close out the quarter. To your point and what Robin Pinchton talked about, South Carolina can score them in bunches, and you got to do what you can, including burning timeouts, to try to keep things in control here the best you can.
Well, and I do think for Mizzou in the half court, they've got to get some ball reversals. We know that they will try to post up the smaller guards for South Carolina.
Blocking foul is going to be called. That will send Dembele to the free throw line as Pow Pow gets whistled for the personal.
And I think for South Carolina, as they make these switches, if I'm Mizzou, I want to do more screening action, hopefully waiting to exploit any kind of miscommunication or misstep by the South Carolina defense.
Excellent free throw shooting team, Missouri, at 76%, but they have made the fewest attempts in the SEC. First one of the night is good for Dembele. This is game one of our Thursday night doubleheader here on the SEC Network. Game two, we'll take it in Asheville. 13th ranked LSU back on track, scoring 106 points last time out. They'll be taking on Vandy. Vandy trying to get right. They've lost four in a row. You were courtside at Memorial on Monday night to see Vandy take on Alabama. That's a team that got off to such a great start in the opening months of the season, trying to find their way right now.
Well, Shea Ralph said, I realized it with my team the last couple of games, game plan means little if you don't have toughness. And speaking of tough, that's Malaysia Fulwiley.
We've got our Columbia version of the microwave right now, because she has come into the game and scored 7 points, seven of the last 9 points, and Fulwiley's got a steal, and she has got two more. How about 9 points in 2.5 minutes? Linthicum lost the handle. Fagan comes away with it. Fagan on the handle. Tried to feed it to Kitts. A little too much for Chloe Kitts to handle. Judd back outside. Three-pointer from Schreck. Nope. And Fulwiley's got it off of Raven Johnson.
Something to watch is just how hard the post for Mizzou are working down low, trying to keep South Carolina's bigs from getting on the low block.
Kitts tiptoes down the lane and gets it for two. Missouri scored the first 6 points of the game. South Carolina has now gone in front by 10. Kitts with the block. Slaughter. Shot clock now at 4. Missouri's got to go. Judd doesn't recognize it. Blocked by Kitts. Defensive stop by Carolina.
Closeout speed by South Carolina on defense in the half court is truly remarkable. I think Mizzou thought they had shot opportunities, at least four different passes in that half court possession, and South Carolina closed that space immediately to take away any shooting opportunities.
I think Fulwiley earned a rest after scoring 9 points in what's being put on the board is 4 minutes. Final minute of the quarter. And a foul's going to be called on Missouri. It's going to be on Sarah Linthicum. That's the first and third on the team. Johnson will trigger the inbound fake and Kitts, Hall, and Johnson on the floor for South Carolina with Raven Johnson. Fagan. Earns a trip to the free throw line.
This is how good South Carolina posts are. Fagan gets the ball in the block area, puts it up, and when she misses because she was fouled, you heard this loud, go across the arena.
So Fagan at the free throw line, averaging better than 6 points a game this season. She had 10 points in the Ole Miss win. Expect her to get some more minutes today with no Cardozo. Hall with an offensive rebound and a second chance here for South Carolina. Fagan on the drive, no. Kitts tried to tip it to Fagan. Hard fall to the ground by Fedrape. And Raven Johnson takes it out for a final shot. The runner won't go. Fagan's got it ripped away. Fedrape's got it. And that will do it for the first quarter. Slow start for South Carolina, but a pretty good finish sparked by the freshman from Columbia.
Absolutely. Fulwiley came in and made an impact immediately. The steal, and takes it coast to coast for the finish.
Back inside Colonial Life Arena as we get ready for quarter number two, some of the images from the first quarter, and you can see Mylesia Fulwiley getting set to come back onto the floor after putting on a show in the first quarter.
Well, this is showtime in Columbia. Mylesia Fulwiley only played 4 minutes, but she was 4 of 5. She did it from deep. She did it with the defense. She did it in transition. This young lady's just special.
Bench scored 10 points. Fulwiley had 9 of the 10 for South Carolina. Paint points 12-0 in favor of South Carolina, even without the 6'7" starter Camilla Cardozo. Still a huge advantage for South Carolina inside.
You're seeing it, Mizzou come out into the 2-3 matchup here in the half court to start the quarter.
Kitts takes it outside for two. 6 points for Kitts.
So far, South Carolina doing a great job getting through the down screens that Mizzou's trying to set.
Last touch by South Carolina will be Mizzou basketball. Missouri last time out playing without Haley Frank. Lost to Tennessee on Sunday by 11. They were down big in the third by 16. But they went on a 15-2 run. They got it to three, and that's been one of the common themes for Missouri. They've lost four in a row, but they won't quit. They will fight. They will scrap.
This is a team, despite all the injuries this season, they keep finding a way. I don't think any lead is truly ever safe because of the three-point shooting ability of this Mizzou ball club.
South Carolina making everything difficult for Missouri right now. Dembele. Watkins was there defensively. Here comes Hall on the run for Kitts. And Kitts gets tied up. Possession arrow will give it to Missouri. Now, we talked about the missing pieces for the Missouri Tigers. Avery Kroenke, Robin Pidgett said she would be a starter this year. Angelique Galakalani played 8 games, all starts, but she's missed 14 in a row. We talked about Haley Frank, who had started 84 consecutive games for Missouri before a DNP against Tennessee last time out.
You just can't replace someone like Haley Frank. Like, I've even watched how South Carolina's gotten downhill and gotten to the rim. Haley Frank's usually there looking to draw a charge, which affects players when they're being aggressive, getting to the rim.
Fulwiley, not this time. Kitts on the offensive glass with a putback for two. 8 for Chloe. Judd tries to drive on the baseline, does a good job to get free for 2. She's got 5.
I love the jump stop and head fake. Already 4 blocks for South Carolina in this game. Mizzou knows they're going for him. Great play by Ashton Judd to get that shot up and in.
Bree Hall from the outside for 2 more. South Carolina 11 of 23 now from the field after a cold start. Dembele off for Judd. Back for Dembele. Shot clock winding down again for Mizzou. It's down to 3. Dembele, another block for South Carolina. Another stop for South Carolina. Carolina basketball. You talked about it right at the top of the telecast. One thing about the South Carolina team, they're making threes for Fulwiley and Watkins, filling up the highlight reel, but the foundation of their success is their defense.
Absolutely. I mean, have you met Don Staley?
Yes.
It's going to be rebounding and defense first and foremost. That's why I even made the comment about post play. She has built this program around great post players. And what you're seeing now, and I said this, I thought defensively they may be in a better situation defending Mizzou tonight.
Well, there's a charge taken for Missouri. Playing the role of Haley Frank is the freshman Hannah Linthicum, I think, or was it Judd taking the charge?
But one thing I want to go back to, I'm eager to see how both Watkins and Chloe Kitts would respond. Their numbers called, and both these young ladies have already stepped up in a big way to make sure that there's not a drop-off without Camilla Cardozo here this evening.
Kicked outside here is Slaughter. Can't get the 3, and Kitts has the rebound. Fulwiley. Fulwiley, beautiful dish. No assist, though. Watkins couldn't get it. I think those two will have a little conversation about that, and then it ends with Watkins frustrated picking up the foul. That's her second. Bree Hall, correction. Bree Hall's got the foul.
It was tremendous screen and roll by Ashlyn Watkins. I think she's as much frustrated that she didn't get the ball to go down.
Cost her friend an assist. Which, and those two kids from Columbia, now see, my laser is going to let her know. Now you caught, I'm trying to build up the assist here a little bit to go with the points. You can't be missing bunnies like that.
It's a great dialogue between the two Columbia natives. Same thing happened on Sunday. Tremendous pass that Fulwiley gave Watkins, and Watkins couldn't finish, and she was like, my bad, buddy, my bad.
Michael Linthicum come into the game. That's off the foot of Fulwiley. 8 to shoot for Mizzou. Mama throws it across. 3-pointer on the way is good. Drained by the freshman, Abby Schreck.
Mizzou now 3 of 11 from deep in this game.
Watkins, Fulwiley has all day to tee up a 3. 12 points for the freshman. 15 points the lead. Dembele, a little hesitation. Slaughter can't get it. Thrown out to Fulwiley. Weaving through traffic, dishing off to Kitts with the finish. biggest smile in the building a second ago may have belonged to Dawn Staley, and then she brought that smile down. Can't let her see that much, but she is a huge fan of the freshman, as you can well imagine.
And she's also a huge fan of sharing the ball and getting the best shot, and that's exactly what that last possession was.
Schreck answers with another three. So back-to-back threes for Abby Schreck. Give her six. That's no good. Judd can just let it go out of play. And it will be Missouri basketball when we come back. South Carolina on top by 14, playing at home on a Thursday night. It's 32-18 here in quarter number two, and Fulwiley has put on a show. 5 of 8 shooting, 12 points, 2 steals, and 2 assists. The plus minus is a 14 in her 9.5 minutes of playing time so far.
Well, in the last 3 games, her minutes per game has increased in every game, and I gotta believe that's because of the defensive pressure she's been applying. And Eric, at that last timeout, Fulwiley was breathing hard because this young lady's not just scoring points, but she's working hard on the defensive end.
She's working on both ends. So, but she's young, and all she needs is like a minute or two to get her breath back. You and I would go find a fainting couch somewhere in the back.
We'd be asleep now. We need a nap.
I need a nap just watching her run up and down the court.
I honestly love the crowd and how they react to her. She gets the ball, and everyone's on the edge of their seat in anticipation.
Missouri basketball out of the media timeout. Raven Johnson will pick up Dembele across half court. Abby Schreck's had the hot hand recently, knocking down back-to-back threes. Here's the freshman Johnson defending Schreck. Judd throws it back to Slaughter. Fagan back on the floor for South Carolina. Now Judd against Kitts. Kitts standing her ground defensively, and it will be South Carolina basketball.
Eric, this is a really good Mizzou offensive ball club, and that's how good the defense is for South Carolina. Their closing speed and length has taken away shot opportunities from the Tigers here this evening.
Fagan finds a cutting Kitts for two. Good play by Sanaya Fagan, finding Kitts on the cut for Carolina.
You see Ashton Judd was trying to post up Pow-Pow, an immediate switch on the backside, and Fagan goes to defender in the low block.
Judd will try a three, won't go down, and Kitts has a rebound. 12 points, 5 rebounds, 4 blocks for Chloe Kitts here tonight. Johnson, quarter three is good. Timeout called by Mizzou. One of the big questions Dawn Staley gets is, you know, how do you keep everybody happy? You've got so many players. You've got, as they just touched on in the studio, Fulwiley coming off the bench. But when players come in, and we just saw Tessa Johnson knock one down from the corner, when your number's called, you're ready to go, and you're put in a position to make a contribution.
I think it demands that these young women are just locked in, because when she gives you the opportunity, you've got to be ready to show results, or she'll go to the next player up. And that's why I think, and you heard me say this, they're so difficult to beat because of their margin of error. And what's that margin of error? 33 bench points a night. We know how good their starters are. With or without Camilla Cardozo, their leading scorer, the bench is always ready to contribute.
Second timeout used by Robin Pinchton here in the first half. Trying to stay within shouting distance of South Carolina by halftime. Carolina's outscored Mizzou 16-8, make it 16-11 here in this second quarter. As another three drops for Mizzou. Pow-Pow. Back out to Fagan. Left open, she'll try it and she'll make it. First field goal for the junior. She's got three.
I asked Dawn Staley today, I said, Sanaya Fagan looks like she's hunting shots. She's being more aggressive offensively. And Don Staley said, yes, maybe a little too aggressive. I want to see the all-around greatness that Sanaya Fagan can provide my ball club.
This one doesn't go down. Shrek has made three threes here in the quarter to keep Missouri this close, but South Carolina continues to try to pull away. Fagan contributes again. A 20-point lead in the first half of the number one team in the country.
I mean, look where Dembele is having to initiate the offense. She was almost at half court.
Johnson with the steal. Dembele with the foul after the turnover. First on Mama Dembele. Checking into the game is Sakima Walker. Most games, if not all games, a couple of exceptions this year because you know, they've played a very challenging schedule. Dawn Staley plays everybody in the first half. She's down two players here today. Camila Cardozo, we talked about at the top with the Brazilian national team for this game and the UConn game. We'll talk about that game in the second half on Sunday. Also, without Sanaya Ja, who we found out pregame is out indefinitely for conduct detrimental to the team. So nine dressed today for South Carolina. Walker into the game means all nine have played here in the first half. Fagan finding Walker in deep. Fedrape knocked it away. He'll stay with South Carolina, 10 to shoot. Pow Pow launches a three, and it's good. Te-Hina Pow Pow, now number two in Division One in three-point shooting percentage, is now one for two today, and now a steal. Raven Johnson takes it away and takes it in for two more.
Eleven turnovers now for Mizzou, 13 points off of those miscues for South Carolina. And they almost get another.
How about the defense, Christy? Seven steals, six blocks for South Carolina here in the first half. Johnson had no one around her, just couldn't control the rebound. It'll be Missouri basketball with under a minute to go here before halftime.
I had a friend ask me on my way down, do you think South Carolina may be looking past Mizzou knowing UConn's on Sunday?
hang on. Can I answer that one for
yes.
you? Because what did you say to me before? Have I met Dawn Staley?
Exactly.
Was that your answer?
That's what I said. No, this team is just operating at a different level this season, fueled by last year's loss to Iowa in the Final Four.
Fagan comes in for another South Carolina block. Johnson trying to get it to Walker, who stuck with it. And she's on the score sheet. She's got two. Player down for Missouri, taking a hard fall, was Abby Schreck. And Robin Pinchton's going to come out and check on the freshman.
Oh.
Who is got a bloody nose.
Abby Schreck.
I think Robin Pinchton also looked over to the officials after checking on her player and just saying there's a reason why she has a bloody nose, and that's the cue to go check it out on the monitor to see if they missed a foul and something should be called. Well, in the first quarter, South Carolina had three separate 7-0 runs. They're on an 11-0 run right now. I think that's just going to be incidental contact. No, Johnson coming down. It's not like Johnson had any kind of wild follow through.
I agree with you, Eric. I think it's incidental. And very unfortunate for Schreck. You just really hope that this young lady's okay, having a tremendous freshman year for Mizzou and a great game so far as well this evening.
I just want to make sure that they take care of the blood on the floor. And nice round of applause from the CLA crowd. paying tribute to Abby Schreck, who will head down beyond the end of the bench to get further attention. Allison Moselle, the athletic trainer for Missouri. So I was just checking on her. It looked like it was a quick check on the monitor with nothing additional or anything being called. So we play on with 33.3 to go before halftime. A reminder, Alyssa and Steffi standing by in the studio. Already one game being played, final minute. Florida trying to hang on against Arkansas in Gainesville. So they'll get you up to date on what's happening at game number one. Some of the news and notes from around the SEC. We've got LSU and Vandy coming up after us here today. South Carolina, of course, the only remaining team that's undefeated in Division I. Tennessee and Alabama meeting tonight. These two teams playing pretty well. You saw Alabama play on Monday night against Vanderbilt and look strong down the stretch in that game to pick up another win.
Sarah Ashley Barker for Alabama is just on a tear right now. Currently Alabama up 2 on Tennessee.
That game is at halftime, so they'll get you up to date on what's happening in that one and take a look at the other games tonight. Texas A&M Ole Miss and Georgia Mississippi State in action on a busy Thursday night in the SEC.
So basically a 3-second difference between shot clock and game clock here for Mizzou, so I think they're going to try to work this down.
Dembele. Back out to Judd. Schreck's been the best three-point shooter for Missouri, but she's out of the game right now. Dembele with 4, with 3, with 2, a turnover. Johnson across half court, takes a peek at the clock, takes it all the way to the basket. And no call, and that does it for the first half. 48 points on the board for a team that's averaging 89 points a game. And the defense outstanding again, keeping Mizzou in check for the final 4 minutes and 15 seconds. 48-21 South Carolina, our score at halftime. South Carolina on top of Mizzou, 48-21 at the break. Eric and Christy back with you here courtside at Colonial Life Arena. Missouri scored the first 6 points of the game, but after that, defense went to work for South Carolina, made everything so tough for Mizzou, and then everyone had a hand in the offense for the number one team in the country.
But I've talked about it. This program was built on great post play. No Carmilla Cardoza tonight, no problem for South Carolina.
Well, let's show you some of what South Carolina did in that first half. And yes, Cardozo is with the Brazilian national team, but they found points in the paint from Chloe Kitts and others.
Chloe Kitts, 6 of 7 in that first half with 12 points. Sanaya Fagan got in on the action with 5 points, working inside and out. Ashlyn Watkins, 7 points in the quarter. Eric, I love the ball movement, the post-to-post action, running the floor in transition, using their athleticism, using their length, using their skill to lead with 24 points in the half.
You see the bench points. Remember, Missouri scored as a team 21 points, so the South Carolina bench outscored the Missouri team in that first half, and it's the 7th time this season that South Carolina has led by at least 25 at halftime. This isn't the first time we've seen this, nor will it be the last. When they are the only undefeated team in the country, they've won 52 in a row at home. They are clicking, and they have the first possession of the third quarter. Individually, Fulwiley and Kitts leading South Carolina in scoring with 12 apiece. Abby Schreck, the leading scorer for Mizzou, with 9. If you're just joining us, Mizzou without their leading scorer and rebounder, Haley Frank, missing her second consecutive game with an injury. Ashlyn Watkins looking for a 3. That would have been a first for Watkins this season. Dembele with a swing into the corner. Fed down Watkins with a hammer block. 8 blocks to go with 8 steals for South Carolina. Johnson from outside, no. Watkins hangs in the air, gets the rebound, and will earn a trip to the free throw line.
Robin Pinchin told her team today they walked through, had to box out the bigs for South Carolina. When they were away from the block, she said, if it's a foot race, if it's about getting up, we're not going to win it. Ashlyn Watkins, case in point, that last possession.
What happens if the person you're trying to box out, like, flies around the intended box out like Ashlyn Watkins can do?
that's where you have to make contact before she gets the momentum going. I mean, I talked to Molly Benetti, head strength and conditioning coach for South Carolina today, and I said, you've been here since their first national championship. All the All-Americans, all the first-round draft picks. And I said, who's the most athletic? And she compared Watkins to Letitia and me here a year ago. But she said, honestly, Watkins has only been with me 2 years, and already she's got the strength, the explosiveness that Amir had. I can't wait to see what happens in the next 2 years.
Here's Grace Slaughter. Slaughter on the run, too strong. Good job by Linthicum to keep it alive. Judd with the three. 8 points for Ashton Judd. Pow Pow will try a three. That one goes down. Second three of the night for the senior. She's got six.
That was a great read by Slaughter on the switch to Faye, but that's the closing speed of South Carolina. Watkins got out there to prevent her from getting a shot off.
Shot clock down to five. Dembele has the shot redirected by Kitts. Watkins on the glass with a follow. Here's Pow Pow. Johnson trying to find Hall in traffic. Back out to Raven Johnson. Johnson accelerates to the basket. Count it and the foul.
Eric, we came in today and we talked about what's missing for both teams. But what is here is two great point guards going head to head. Mama Dembele gets beat off the bounce and Linthicum rotates over, but far too late for the explosive play by Raven Johnson.
Good sign here. There's Abby Schreck checking into the ball game, and I got a quick glimpse, but Brad Wilson, our director, I'm sure if he wants to get a close-up, if he wants to, because I believe that right nostril is packed pretty tight for Abby after taking that shot to the nose in the first half. Players get tied up, and the possession arrow will give it to South Carolina. Oh, yeah, Brad, I can always count on you. So we're going with one nostril for Abby the rest of the way, it would appear, but good to see her back on the floor.
Shrek has played off guard on and off throughout the season because of Mama Dembele being the starting point guard, but she's played a lot of backup point today because of Frank being out, playing a lot of off guard for Mizzou.
In the first meeting this season between these two teams, you touched on a little bit earlier, Mama Dembele was out of that game, so who was the point guard in that game for Missouri?
Haley Frank.
There's a three. Grace Slaughter knocks it down for Mizzou. Eight for the freshman.
Mizzou now up to seven made threes in this game.
Kitts on the drive, no. And Schreck controls the rebound for Missouri. Needs help. Dembele.
She's got to get it across.
She does just in time. It was close. Kick to Slaughter. On the drive, breakdown defensively, and Missouri with the basket. The drive to the hoop by Judd. She's into double figures now at 10. Bree Hall. Hall, tough shot, makes it.
And that's exactly how Mizzou wanted to defend it. Robin Pinchon said, we can't take everything away. This team is just way too good, but we just want to try to get them out of the rhythm shots. That time, Bree Hall just too good offensively.
Here's Judd. Judd, Kitts has been really good tonight. Both ends of the floor, makes it tough on Judd. Slaughter challenge shot, makes it with the shot clock winding down. Slaughter into double figures now with 10 for Mizzou.
Mizzou going small now. Schreck defending Chloe Kitts. Now's the switch.
That won't drop. That's Raven Johnson flying in for the offensive rebound. Pow Pow can't get the three. Hall can't get the follow. Missouri basketball.
It's a nice box out by Eddie Fight down low.
Throughout the season, we've seen South Carolina really come out of the locker room and find that extra gear. So far, Missouri hanging tough here with Dawn Staley's team in the third quarter. They have outscored South Carolina 10-7. In the first meeting this year, Mizzou and South Carolina each scored 18 points in that third quarter. So some good adjustments, as you would expect as well, from Missouri here to try to turn things around here at South Carolina.
But this is a Mizzou ball club, high basketball IQ. Just going through their game plan today, I was really impressed. The problem is the quickness of South Carolina.
Oh, Raven Johnson got the steal, made a beautiful move for the finish. Shrek has it rejected by Watkins. Out to Kitts. Pow Pow on the crossover. Fed it to Watkins, and that's going to be an offensive foul called on Ashlyn Watkins. That'll be her second personal foul. And that will get us to a media timeout with 4:22 to go in the third quarter.
Well, Raven Johnson, one of the top point guards in the SEC, but she's doing it with defense, active hands, and then it's just pure speed to the rim for two.
I like to think Christy Thomas-Scuddy is someone who dresses with a lot of style.
No, there's Don style.
And then there's Christy style.
And then Christy style's well below that.
Wow, already 16 seasons now, 24th overall. This is the team that, as we mentioned before, has won 40 in a row in SEC regular season games, 52 in a row at home. And they are rolling right now. They've got a big challenge coming up on Sunday. We'll talk more about that in the fourth quarter, as the UConn Huskies get set to come here to Colonial Life Arena. Guess who's in the game? Malaysia Fulwiley. Guess who's filling up the highlight reel? Malaysia Fulwiley.
Mizzou now going to that five-out offense. Robin Pinchin said, ideally you want to play inside out, but the shot blocking ability of South Carolina has made that very difficult tonight.
Good finish by Judd around Watkins, looking for yet another block. Watkins has three blocks tonight. Chloe Kitts has five as a team, South Carolina with 10. Hall, that won't drop. Fagan into the game, looking for the putback, and she'll look for points at the free throw line. Starts with the defense.
Absolutely. Malaysia Fulwiley just D'ing up as soon as Mizzou crosses half court. Quick hands, disruptive, and then the beautiful finish.
That's what I love about what we've seen. We've seen her in person three times now, and we've watched all the highlights, and we've watched plenty on TV. She can finish with either hand. She's bringing the finger roll back a little bit too for old schoolers like me. Love that as well. But you've talked about it a couple times here today. Finding that next part of her game on the defensive end and turning that into points has been pretty impressive to watch.
Well, now seeing what she's doing defensively, how disruptive she is, I get why Dawn has been all over her to be better on the defensive end, because that's a difference maker. Because we've seen Raven Johnson, we've seen Bree Hall be defensive lockdown players. Now you throw Fulwiley in as well. It's just tremendous perimeter pressure that they can apply.
Mama Dembele back into the game, picked up her dribble in front of Fulwiley. Shrek can't get that three. Second chance here for Missouri. Watkins there defensively and knocked it away out of the hands of Fedrape. It will stay with Mizzou with 14 to shoot. Here's Mama Schreck over Pow Pow off the mark. Bree Hall brings it back the other way. Fulwiley finds Fagan. Fourteen points, three assists now for Fulwiley, who gets called for the foul running over Dembele.
Actually, I think they got that on Fagan. Before that, Fulwiley rewarding the big for running the floor. And you see Fulwiley's head's up that entire possession looking for someone to beat her down the floor.
Fedrape, no room to move. Finds Slaughter, in and out for three, and the rebound for Pow Pow. Fulwiley to Hall.
Something to keep an eye on is Mizzou has gone fairly small here this evening. The majority of the minutes have been the four-guard lineup with the post rotating in. Are they starting to fatigue because they've worked so hard against the bigger, faster South Carolina team?
Dembele with her first field goal on one end and then a foul on Mizzou on the other end. Substitutions for South Carolina. Tessa Johnson and Raven Johnson coming onto the floor. Bree Hall and Te-Hina Pow Pow will sit down. Abby Fight coming back on for Mizzou. Schreck will take a seat.
Mizzou staying in the 2-3 matchup on the out-of-bounds defense.
Fagan had it knocked away, and a foul is going to be called.
I think they got that foul on Grace Slaughter.
Either Slaughter or Fedra? Yeah, Slaughter, you're right. So Slaughter picks it up and Fagan to the free throw line. Another one to come. Gymnastics triple header for Friday Night Heights. You can see the teams. Christy Thomas-Scuddy, take it away with your weekly analysis of Friday Night Heights.
Well, I'm going to focus on the bottom one, the Iron Bowl of gymnastics. Number 7 Alabama goes to number 14 Auburn. Head coach of the Tide, Ashley Priest Johnson, won back-to-back national championships as a gymnast at Alabama and was the associate head coach at Auburn before she came back home to Tuscaloosa to lead the Tide. The two teams have faced each other 28 times since 07. The Tide has won 25 of those meetings.
And that is your weekly Friday Night Heights preview starring Christy Thomas-Scuddy.
Did I nail the landing?
You stuck the landing. Well done. And sticking a three is Abby Fight. I would have liked for you to work in the fact that it's Alabama-Auburn. It's at Auburn-Neville Arena. That means that Alabama has to deal with the gymnasties.
Ooh, I didn't know that was a term. Mm-hmm. See, you teach me something new.
Fulwiley, that won't drop. Oh, Watkins got there on the glass. And the putback for two. 9.6 boards for Ashlyn Watkins. That won't drop. And here comes Johnson up to Fulwiley. What will she do? Almost. Even I was on the edge of my... Did you see that?
Can we get a camera on Eric? Because I feel like everyone needs to be able to watch this man every time Fulwiley gets it. He has stood up. His hands are in the air on different plays. You're pure entertainment.
I am following the lead of the fans here in this building because that's how they have felt. Of course, a lot of fans from around here could follow her progress in high school before playing here in her hometown of Columbia. But someone to come in at the Division I level for the number one team in the country and have that confidence to bring that game. We were talking to Jolette Law today because before there was a Malaysia Fulwiley, there was Jazzy Jolette Law, who, in Jolette's words, had sauce. She had a handle, but she just talks about that next thing that Fulwiley has.
To quote Jolette, we haven't even seen half the tricks in her bag yet.
Maybe we haven't seen a tenth of the tricks that Fulwiley has. Just there's Jolette right there.
I mean, she was comparing Fulwiley to some of the greats in our game, Tasha Pointer, Cappy Poindexter. And she said, hey, they all had sauce. Fulwiley's got even more sauce.
Here's Judd. Dembele gets past Fulwiley, a little short on the drive, and here comes Fulwiley the other way. That's going to be after the horn, and that will do it for the third quarter. 70 on the board for South Carolina through three. We head to the fourth. Number one, South Carolina, looking to stay undefeated.
Welcome back to Columbia, where the freshman phenom, Malaysia Fulwiley, has shown a little bit of her bag of tricks. The assist in transition, in the half court, creating for her team, creating for herself, knocking them down from deep. I said it the first time we covered her, and nothing's changed. Never look away when this young lady's on the floor.
You see the numbers so far, 15 points, 4 assists, 6 of 11 shooting for the freshman from Columbia.
And 3 steals.
Yeah, just throw that in for good measure. And I'll give you one more, no turnovers. You know, when you play at that speed and you're trying to do things with, what are we gonna call it, a little sauce? There's a propensity to turn the basketball over. It hasn't happened for her here tonight. Raven Johnson, another one who's excellent at taking care of the basketball, leading the SEC in assist-to-turnover ratio, second in Division I at 3.4-1. Kitts takes the contact. They play on. Second chance here with Fulwiley. Well, almost a turnover. It is not a turnover, though. Let the record show that I was talking about no turnovers, and she almost had one.
No, Chloe Kitts preserved it to make sure her teammate didn't get that.
It's going to be Mizzou basketball as we play here in the first minute of the fourth quarter.
Eric, I've talked about some of the individual defensive performance of Fulwiley, Raven Johnson. But one thing tonight, every time Mama Dembele has gotten downhill, gotten in the paint, you're seeing 5 white jerseys collapse, just making it really hard for the point guard to do anything.
Here she is on the drive. Missouri trying to move, but you see how quick South Carolina is on the defensive end, and then a foul is called on the reach-in on Chloe Kitts. It would be very easy, I would think, if you looked at the scoreboard and what's happening in this game, that you wouldn't have to sprint on a closeout or make life difficult for Mama Dembele, but it doesn't work that way. And there's going to be a timeout called here by Missouri to avoid a 5-second call, and we will take a timeout as well. It comes with 9:09 to go here in the fourth quarter with South Carolina on top of Mizzou by 32. Sunday, 2 o'clock Eastern time, you can see it on ESPN. The 11th-ranked UConn Huskies will be here at Colonial Life Arena to take on number one South Carolina, their 14th meeting all time. I take your attention to the bottom line there, that South Carolina in recent history has had the upper hand on UConn. Huskies coming off a win last night against Seton Hall, Gino Auriemma's 1,200th career win. What do you think about the matchup? And we do know that Camila Cardozo will be with Team Brazil, and she will not be here for South Carolina.
Well, we know that UConn doesn't have a lot of depth due to some injuries on that ball club. I still think the difference maker in that game will come down to the bench play. And that's why I give the nod to South Carolina. Now, don't get me wrong, it's going to be a heck of a game. Paige Becker's on the big stage against this defense will be something to watch.
It's interesting, too, because UConn, you mentioned the injuries. They play 7 pretty much, including 4 freshmen, so this will be a big challenge. They've won 3 in a row since losing to Notre Dame. Their best player as of late has been Aaliyah Edwards, 24 points a game and 11.5 rebounds over the last four games, shooting at 68%. So with Edwards for UConn, that's some post strength there that Connecticut will bring here. But in this atmosphere, with this team the way they're playing, that is going to be a big challenge for the Huskies come Sunday afternoon.
But I do think for UConn, the X factor will be Nika Mule. She has to avoid foul trouble and stay on the floor for UConn to have a chance.
That was costly in the loss of Notre Dame, certainly.
Absolutely.
So that's coming up on Sunday as those two teams will get together. Now, five players out with season-ending injuries for Connecticut. We talked about Missouri, how they're down three starters here tonight. Staying healthy is so hard to do. And we've seen it from coast to coast impacting many teams. Five on the shot clock. Walker put it up. Kitt's fighting for it. Missouri comes away with it. Fedrapi across half court, guarded by Johnson. Back off from Mama. Open look in the corner. Slaughter passed on the three. Took a look again. Now over to Sarah Linthicum. And Slaughter, after passing on a couple of closer looks, tries the deep look, and that one comes up short. Class is always in session for Robin Pinchton's young team. There's no question about it. Always something to learn from, and this is going to be a tough learning experience here tonight. Mama Dembele checking out.
Well, Eric, you and I talked about it on our way over to the gym for shoot-arounds today. It's hard to be the leading scorer coming in here to play against the South Carolina team because they're going to game plan against you and look to take you out of it. And without Haley Frank, we wondered where would the offense come from if South Carolina was able to take Mama out of the game.
Here's Fulwiley. Chloe Kitts has checked out of the game, played very well tonight. Fulwiley can't hit from outside, and Judd's got the rebound. If Kitts has done 12 points, 8 rebounds, 2 assists here tonight, and I think the final total was 5 blocks. It was. Turnover, be South Carolina basketball. Bree Hall coming back into the game for Carolina, and Raven Johnson will check out. Well, you got Watkins and Fulwiley on the floor for South Carolina. File that under anything could happen, so do not turn the channel. Here's Johnson to Walker. Walker, tough shot, muscled it in for two, and a chance for a three-point play.
The senior, Sakia Walker, you know, has got to start getting ready to come up big with UConn coming to town. That time just muscles it up for the and one.
South Carolina's known for a long time, according to Dawn Staley, that Camila Cardoso was going to be playing with her national team in Brazil. They came up short today, by the way, in their opener in the Olympic qualifier. So they've had a chance to get players a little bit kind of in that mind, Fulwiley almost with steel, in that mindset of more is going to be expected from you with Cardoso out. Walker's one of those who's getting a little bit more time. That's taken away by Johnson. We saw Kitts play very well tonight. Watkins making an impact. Fulwiley couldn't get it.
And for the South Carolina fans that are watching, Camila Cardoso tonight, 11 points, 6 rebounds, but unfortunately they couldn't get the win.
On the drive, a foul is called and a trip to the free throw line. Team USA, by the way, their opener in Antwerp in front of, there's the what Camila posted on social media. That was yesterday, talking about today's matchup against Australia. Aaliyah Boston did not play today for Team USA. They played in front of 13,700 fans in Belgium. That was a record in Belgium for most people attending a women's team event to see Team USA take on Belgium. And Brianna Stewart had a tip in at the buzzer to give Team USA the victory.
So you're saying the growth of women's basketball is not just here in the U.S.
Speaking of international flavor, the freshman from Germany chatting with her head coach heading to the bench. Watkins lost the handle, picked up by Slaughter. Schreck. And thrown away by Schreck. Turnover for Missouri. South Carolina basketball. That's 18 turns now for Mizzou. South Carolina forces on average 16 a game. They forced 21 against Ole Miss last time out. Fulwiley. That won't drop. Batted out by Michael Linthicum. Schreck. Rhythm three. Abby Schreck knocks down her fourth three-pointer of the night.
I really like Abby Schreck's game. I think there's only huge upside for her because she's got great ball IQ. And again, this is the combo guard for Mizzou, having to move off guard a lot tonight without Haley Frank on the floor.
Fight will launch a three. That's no good. And here comes South Carolina's Johnson. She'll pull up for three and make it. Tessa Johnson buries her second three-pointer. And a timeout's going to be called here by Dawn Staley because she wants to make a substitution. Ashlyn Watkins will come out of the game. Ashlyn finishes with 9 points, 7 rebounds, 3 assists, 3 blocks, 3 steals. That's a pretty good night's work for the sophomore. Timeout, 4:28 to go in the fourth, all Carolina. Yes. 75-42, South Carolina, 4:28 to go in the fourth quarter. At the moment, South Carolina doesn't have to worry too much about bracketology, and Charlie Cream doesn't have to worry about South Carolina, Christy, because if there was ever a surefire lock overall number one seed, what do we had? The number two team has lost 8 times this season, the number two in the AP Top 25 poll, but number one has been untouchable so far. So they're the projected number one seed. After that, it gets a little cloudy, according to Charlie.
Well, LSU, a lock right now as well. The seeding for them is still up in the air. I want everybody to look at the bottom, though. A week ago, Charlie had a couple of SEC teams playing in the opening round against one another to advance. So a lot to be played for here in the SEC.
You will see LSU and Vanderbilt in game two of our doubleheader coming up at the top of the hour from Nashville. Out of the timeout, Fedropi on the floor. Fagan with the tie-up. Possession arrow will give it to South Carolina. Already tonight, Florida with a win over Arkansas. Leilani Correa had an off night, just 20. The microwave was just on 50% power, apparently, but a win for Florida.
It was a low slow cook tonight.
So that means Arkansas is now 5-5 in the SEC. Walker will try it from the outside. Johnson's got the rebound, fed it to Fulwiley for two more. 17 for Fulwiley, her career best, 21 against Texas A&M.
She
got a deflection. Numbers back the other way. Hall's got Fulwiley on her left, and a nifty little finish by Bree Hall. 8 for Hall. Again, great balanced scoring. When you take a look at South Carolina, their leading scorer this season, who isn't here, is Camilla Cardozo at just under 14 points a game. That's 16th in the SEC. It just shows you the balance that they have. Everyone contributing again here tonight.
Well, we've seen the variety of skill sets by players. We've seen how they can beat you with just their defense. We've seen how the post can beat you down low. The guards can beat you from outside. It's a balanced team, is the South Carolina, and I'm glad I don't have to game plan against them.
The next team that has to game plan against South Carolina is UConn. We're going to talk about that meeting coming on Sunday. Onto the floor for Mizzou. Lucia Milkovic, the freshman from Croatia, is into the game. 81 now on the board for South Carolina. Good Robbie. Fulwiley comes back the other way. Fulwiley to the basket, all the way with the finish. Closing in on 2 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. And Rappi was fouled, and she'll go to the free throw line to shoot two.
Well, South Carolina now with 15 steals on the night, and this is probably the highlight of them all. Into the bag of tricks yet again for Fulwiley.
19 now for the freshman on 8 of 16 shooting to go along with 4 assists. And a couple of steals. 2 of the 15, as Christy mentioned. And some hard work on defense that you pointed out right from the very beginning tonight.
Well, what I love is after that great make, she came back down and was D'ing up yet again. Now she's looking a little fatigued.
Look at that little pass from Milkovic. Another trip to a free throw line for a teammate after the foul called on South Carolina. Fagan picks up the foul, and Slaughter will go to the line. Missouri will host Auburn on Sunday, then a couple on the road at Arkansas and at Florida. Levin points for Slaughter. Deep three launched by Tessa Johnson. And it'll be Mizzou basketball. Slaughter across half court. Mizzou scored the first 6 points of the game, couple of three-pointers, but then South Carolina, after a little bit of a slow start, went to work. Slaughter for three, no. Fedrape with the offensive rebound. Back over to Slaughter. Fedrape on the turnaround. Walker with the block for South Carolina. 11th block for South Carolina tonight. Johnson sets for three. Walker flips it out to Hall. Fulwiley calls for it. Oh boy. Picked up by Mizzou.
I just love the fans here. They're just disappointed that shot didn't go down. The very loud groan by the fans. Or that was you, I'm not sure which one.
Well, we're launching threes 3 steps behind the line. That take won't go. Walker's got the rebound. Here's Fulwiley, one last chance to fill up the highlight reel. She cannot. Fagan's got it, didn't hit the rim. Dawn Staley just tells. Tessa Johnson to pull it back out. Robin Pinchton and Dawn Staley with an embrace still. Could have to be one more inbound. That's a shot clock expiration, so it'll be Missouri needing to put the ball into play, and that'll be it. But the coaches are going to continue to pay their respects, and that will do it. 83-45. 22-0. Number one, South Carolina rolls again at home. That's 53 straight home wins with UConn next on the schedule here on Sunday.
Nothing surprised us. They did it with the defense. They did it with the rebounding. Tremendous rim protection by South Carolina tonight. And a lot of nice plays on offense.
Starts with the defense. 15 steals, 11 blocks tonight for South Carolina as a team. They had 19 assists on the 35 field goals. Mylesia Fulwiley led the way with 19 points, added 4 assists. Chloe Kitts was very strong with the 12 points, 8 rebounds, and 5 blocks here tonight.